to you as a Mastercam programmer, it's the same thing as you would be doing if you previously moved everything around the center of rotation. Literally, you just define a plane, you know, your T plane, C plane, whatever, and then the control outputs, oh, this takes, you know, maybe A90 and C125 to get to. And the same thing's happening here. It's just that your control is now taking into account that, okay, when I rotated that A axis 90 degrees, I had to keep that relationship between my zero and the part in place. But yeah, functionally, I mean, there's really no change to the way you're doing things other than you don't have to move them to the physical center of rotation in Mastercam anymore. And that's one note that I want to throw out there is part of the real value of this is when you're getting parts in, I always teach people, never move the part. Bring the Mastercam WCS to the part, not the other way around. And some of you guys, I saw on the attendance list, I know you guys are doing aerospace parts. And for you, you're already used to that. That's not new information. But to a lot of guys, and I'm still surprised by how many files I get in, that the part has physically been moved to the center of rotation. And that is a big no-no in a lot of aerospace shops because you can't validate the data chain all the way through.